the hottest club in town, Disney's House of Mouse.
Who's that knocking at the House of Mouse? We're all knocking at the House of Mouse. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're all rocking at the House of Mouse. We're having a ball and rocking the hall. So come on in,
to the House of Mouse.
Started, so come on in. The good times are all just about to begin. Step inside, we're gonna have some fun. There's plenty of room here for everyone.
The gang's all here and we're hanging out.
All this fun makes you jump and shout. Hey, little girl, I wanna dance with you. We'll find so many things to do. So come on in, we're gonna shake the house. We're having a ball.
House of Mouse.
And now, ladies and Jungle Man, toys and squirrels, it's Mickey Mouse!
Oh, didn't think I'd make it. There was this delay on the freeway, you know. Can we show the clip?
Has been seen leading police on a wild ride. The driver is an unidentified resident of Toad Hall.
Here, Pluto, take this note to Mickey right away.
Let me go merrily on my way to nowhere in particular.
Okay, Housketeers, we got a great show lined up for you. A couple of cartoons and special musical guests, O'Malley and the Alley, huh? Scratch the cats. Our musical guest is Big Bad Wolf Daddy. Why, this is great. This is a disaster. Who booked the Big Bad Wolf?
Donald did, so he can sign my autograph book.
But don't you remember what happened last time he was here? No way I'm putting that blowhard on stage.
How? I earned this club, too.
I'll help you decide. I don't want to come between you. And that's my final decision.
Donald, call the Big Bad Wolf and cancel.
Julius.
You're not the Big Bad Wolf.
No, I'm Ludwig von Drake, Professor of Rage Management. The professor, and that's me, is reaching a breakthrough with the Big Bad Wolf, and I have concluded that all of that huffing and puffing is triggered by doors.
Doors? Huh, and I thought it was pigs.
That's a load of urban myth. It's all about the door. Therefore, before my windbag client gets here, we got to get rid of every door.
Or he'll huff and puff.
And blow the house in.
Hello, Donald.
Any sign of the Big Bad Wolf?
Uh-uh, not yet.
Good. Next, we got something you hardly ever see. Donald Duck being charming.
Forward, three steps back. Careful not to step on cracks. Good luck keeps me right on track.
Just roll the ball.
Wait a minute. For good luck.
You gotta be kidding.
You do believe in good luck, don't you, Donald?
No, it's a bunch of phooey.
I'll show you phooey. I don't understand it.
We have a winner!
Yippee!
Teddy bear, t-shirt, or candy? Take your pick.
Bonbons! Still don't believe in luck, Donald?
Out of my way, Twitch.
Big idea?
Sorry.
We have a winner!
I won!
Black cat doll, ladder hat, or a mirror? Take your pick.
I'll take the mirror. Oh, boy! Uh-oh. Here, Daisy, for you.
No! Get that thing away from me! Broken mirrors are bad luck!
That's preposterous.
It wasn't me.
It's the censor monkeys. They stopped the cartoon.
That's correct. This sequence is too violent. Donald slides along the tracks of a roller coaster,
stumbles through a shooting gallery, careens dangerously through bumper cars, and crashes through an entire hall of mirrors. And in the end, he is unharmed.
In truth, he would at least have multiple broken bones.
Or worse.
We gotta show Donald with broken bones? Or worse?
Absolutely not.
That would be inappropriate. We suggest that Donald wear protective headgear.
And pillows.
And an inner tube.
And get rid of all those horrible crashy-smashy sound effects. We prefer comical sound effects.
Was that comical enough?
Fortune teller. Everything is fate, dear duck. Bad or good, there is no luck. Well, if the fortune teller says it, it must be true. I guess you were right, Donald. There's no such thing as luck, good or bad. So now that neither of us believes in bad luck, and despite all of the uncanny things that just happened to you, we can go on that ride.
Oh, no!
Come on! Don't be such a scaredy feathers. If there's no such thing as bad luck, then nothing bad will happen to you, right?
Right.
Under. What a cute black kitty. How pretty. Ooh, scary. That was close. That was fun, and nothing bad happened at all.
Congratulations! You are a lucky 1,000,000th rider!
Huh?
And as a special prize, you get to go on the ride one more time!
Yippee!
Just my luck.
Say, Donald, whatever happened to that lucky charm?
Here it is.
All right, campers, give it up for the Quackstreet Boys.
Oh.
Hi, I'm Waiter, and I'll be your Goofy tonight. Now, let me tell you our specials. We got bread knobs and fish sticks, Cruella de Vil, peg leg pizza, never never lamb, stromboli ravioli, and polka hummus.
Don't tell me. Tell the guests. Tell the guests.
What do you think I am? Stupid? Oh, oh.
That's that.
Now, don't forget. You keep the wolf from the doors and your chinny chin chin, and you're gonna be all right. See you later.
Witcha! Big Bad Wolf Daddy is in the house. And, my dressing room is where?
I'll show ya.
Hey, that's my room.
Is that a door?
Door is? What are you doing here?
Well, thanks for letting me in.
Well, so far, so good.
Maybe for you. I had to cancel old Mally and the Alley Cats. You got any idea how mad cats get when a mouse fires them?
Showbiz, it happens.
Donald, that big bad wolf's a loose cannon. If he blows, he's gonna take us all with him.
Don't worry, Mickey. The kids love him.
And I love him, too. Think you'll sign my book?
No!
Mickey, you need to manage your rage. Here's a friend of mine. His name is Ludwig.
Oh!
I'm so excited about the Big Bad Wolf coming to the club. Some people say he's a blowhard, but I think he's a genius. Did you see him in that pigs thing? He was brilliant. He is so good. And I'm gonna get him to sign my autograph book. This is the greatest day of my life.
Minnie? Minnie, are you still there? Minnie?
Bon appetit.
That's right, Pluto. It's time for you to get the paper. Say, Pluto, you want to fetch the paper?
Yeah.
Ha-cha-cha. A free newspaper. Here I was off to the newsstand to buy one, and lucky me, I find one sitting right here in front of Mickey's house. What's your problem, dog? Get your own paper. The other side of town and step on it. What the? Yay for Mickey's dog. Hooray, hooray. Here's your dumb old paperback. Well, what more do you want from me, you mutt?
Atta boy, Mortimer. And now, my very special guest, Big Bad Wolf.
The big bad wolf, the big bad wolf, the big bad wolf. Who's afraid of the big bad wolf? Certainly not I. Who's afraid of the big bad wolf? I ain't afraid of no big bad wolf. Slap that bass, beat that drum. Ready or not, folks, here I come.
Yeah.
my siren's born.
You all look out when I blow my horn.
Big Bad Wolf needs to play.
I love to bring down the house.
Look at it. He's mind dust.
Yeah, I know. Wow, that Big Bad Wolf Daddy was really cool. And so is his next cartoon.
Ladies and gentlemen, is this what you would call today's modern man? With his oversized shoes, old pants, ugly shirt, and loser vest, looking like his mother dressed him?
Don't forget your hat, dear.
No! The modern man can't afford to look like something from the past. He's got to have style. He's got to be groovy, cool, and fly.
Gorge! I want to be gravy, cold, and lie.
That's fly. Well, to understand today's styles, one must understand the origins. Let us begin with the culture of yesterday. The sensational 60s. Early in the decade, the dominant style came from overseas in the form of the British Invasion, a time of European suits and snappy rock music. It was an energetic style, and many loved it, especially the girls. The button-down look of the early 60s soon gave way to another British trend. The swinging Carnaby Street look. A time when men's clothes were more colorful, more baroque, more everything.
Goofy, baby.
The mid-60s were exhausting and made way for a mellower bent. The hippie movement. A time of love, flower power, and groovy bell-bottoms.
Bell-bottoms?
The girls also appreciated this earthy look.
Hey, sunshine.
Watch it, brother.
The rebellious 60s soon gave way to the happening 70s, where hip was a state of mind. Gold, polyester, and plenty of body hair were essential to the smooth bicentennial look.
I'm a wild and crazy goof.
Soon, popular entertainment took over as the fashion statement, especially the sci-fi style, with its alien garb and shocking hairdos.
I have a bad feeling about this.
Of course, the accessories were to die for.
Ooh, shiny.
But the 70s also had a look that was bigger than outer space, and they named it disco! With stylish threads so tight, they looked painted on.
You're telling me!
And the higher the platform shoes, the hipper you were. But it wasn't enough just to look good. You also had to move good. You had to show the ladies you were a dancer, that you could do the hustle, the locomotion, even the disco duck. Yes, the ladies loved the dancer. Soon the 70s boogied into the night, making way for the totally awesome 80s, where popular trends bespoke the rebellion of youth, a time of leather, guitars, and heavy face makeup. A time to say, don't mess with me, I'm a hot rocker. But those days of music fashion were soon replaced by a more chic, prosperous look. The stylin' Miami nightclub scene, complete with yuppie ponytail. Clothes weren't enough, however. The trendsetter also needed an awesome set of wheels.
Righteous.
Yes, the girls thought this look was totally rad. The 80s gave way to the information superhighway and the technology of the 90s, heralded by the emergence of the grungy hackers of Generation X.
Hey, baby, what's your email address?
Talk to the hand. There's no URL on this server.
Hmm? Another popular trend was the explosion of the inner city style. Welcome to rap. In the hip-hop world, you want to be fat.
Fat?
It's these pants, right?
You want to be fly.
It's open.
You want to relax, homie.
Who's homely?
You want to get down with your bad self.
Peace. I'm out.
As we bid adieu to the 90s, we face a new millennium, the bright new tomorrow of the 21st century. Who knows what groundbreaking trends await us in the... Hey, there you go again with those clothes, stuck in the style of the past. No one in their right mind would dress like that.
What's up, Goofy?
That's hot.
Pretty fly for a goof guy.
Well, I guess this only proves that in the world of popular culture, what's old is new. Congratulations, my friend. You're in perfect style.
Big Bad, well, I guess you're not such a blowhard after all.
You're too kind. Huh? Where do you have think you're going? Back in the case.
Hey, you can't treat the pigs like that.
No, I've got a play or fillet contract.
So long as we play, he won't fillet.
Doors? Doors? I'm gonna huff. I'm gonna puff. And I'm gonna blow the house in!
That was too cool. Sign my book.
Welp, we gotta get this all cleaned up by next time. See ya real soon. Don't forget, he was your guest.
What?
Hi there, it's Goofy. Everybody knows that Pluto's one of my best friends, but I just learned that dogs have been man's best friend for thousands of years. Yep, even back in the days of the ancient Egyptians, dogs were guarding houses and fetching sticks and sometimes causing lots of mischief. Yep, just like my pal Pluto. See you later.
At the House of Mouse.